Ma, you're giving Catherine more than me. Give me some more there.
Hmm. Did you ever have a bit of respect, for God's sake?
Sorry, Ma. Can I lick the spoon?
Maeve Doyle, I'll scalp you.
If I ever leave this world alive, well, thank you for the things you did in my life.
I met Tammy after speaking on a panel about independent filmmaking and the making of Kissing Jessica Stein. And she came up to me afterward and said, oh, I'm filming a movie and I think you'd be perfect for one of the roles. And then she sent me the script of Red Roses and Petrol. And I read it and I really was taken with how it depicts a family in all of its good and all of its bad, you know, and all of its joy and love, all wrapped up in its dysfunction and its bad and its good, you know. I thought it was a very rich depiction of a family.
I'm a bit jittery tonight.
I can see.
The neurotic Dial family getting together and all.
Every family has their share of problems.
Yeah, but we have a few more.
I think she is experiencing this kind of classic conflict between loyalty to one's family and a desire to get out into the world and make one's own way in the world. And I feel that she's been itching to get out for a long time, but she feels if she does, she'll be abandoning her mom or letting her mom down a little bit. And it's actually her brother, Johnny, who helps her discover what she really needs to do. And he's generally the troublemaker and just a complete rabble-rouser. So the fact that she has this like very tender moment with Johnny where he helps her see, you know, and helps her have some real insight into her own life, it's really, really kind of sweet. And again, just reflects the layers that exist within families.
Oh, God, Catherine, you look like a treat. Doesn't she, Maeve? Mm. Oh, stop. You'd look lovely too if you'd buy yourself a few new things.
Ma.
I wish you would.
Well, actually, I think my favorite line is when my mom, Moya, says to me, or about me, whether I'm going to go out to a pub that night or something like this. She says, oh, not my big lump. And because my character is really the couch potato in this family. I am the lump, you know. And I love that it really reflects my relationship with my mom in the film, which is really that I've kind of stayed home. I've kind of stuck by my mom. I look after her a little bit, but she looks after me. And so there's this kind of mutual love and care that goes on between us, but we're also kind of nudgy with each other and we're getting on each other's nerves a little bit and everything, and we do have this kind of banter back and forth. So when she talks about me as her big lump, you know, I just feel that captures a lot of the spirit of the film.
The water is wide, I can cross over, and neither have I wings to fly. Give me a boat that can carry two, and both shall grow. My love and I.
Go on, Maeve, you got a grand voice.
There's more heart, generally, on an indie film. Most people are working for very little pay and, you know, with very long hours because they love the script. It was that way on Kissing Jessica Stein, and it's been that way on Red Roses. No one's making a lot of money on this movie, but we all just have responded to the material. And so you become this really, really intense and loving family that wants to, you know, be there for each other, and, you know, come hell or high water, we're going to get this movie made. And that's really what's beautiful about independent filmmaking. It's kind of, there's more of a heightened emotion about it, I think.